Hello everyone, welcome to the prerequisite course on television and video engineering. I am the subject teacher of this course. My name is Amol Pardhi. After completion of this prerequisite course, you will be able to understand the basic concept of signal transmission and reception of television system. For the signal transmission and reception concepts, students needs to have basic knowledge of antenna and a good hold on communication system. In last semester, you have understood the antenna and wave propagation subject. In that subject, you already have understood all the basic concepts of the antenna. So I am going to recall those concepts in this prerequisite course. So first I will explain what is an antenna, then what is the need of an antenna, then with the help of block diagram, I will explain in detail antennas in wireless communication system, and at last television transmission reception antennas with their various types. So what is an antenna? So here is the proper definition. Actually, an antenna is a transducer which converts electrical power into electromagnetic waves and vice versa. Antenna can be of either of transmitting antenna or a receiving antenna. Transmitting antenna is one which converts electrical signals into electromagnetic waves and radiates them, whereas the receiving antenna is one which converts electromagnetic waves from the received beam into electrical signal. So in two-way communication, the same antenna can be used for both transmission and reception. So I can say here the best example of two-way communication is television antennas, and in short, the antenna is also known as the aerial. Now what is the need of an antenna? So here in the field of communication system, whenever the need for wireless communication arises, there occurs the necessity of an antenna. So antenna has the capability of sending or receiving the electromagnetic waves for the sake of communication, where you cannot expect to lay down a wiring system. Here I just wanted to give an example. Consider the scenario that in order to contact a remote area, the wiring has to be laid down throughout the whole route along the valleys or the mountains, the tedious path, the tunnels, etc. To reach the antenna location, the evolution of wireless technology has made this whole process very simple. And that's why I can say here the antenna is the key element of this wireless technology. Now, so let us just look at where antennas are used, which is shown in this block diagram. So this block diagram, I can say this is the basic example of the wireless communication system. So the antennas are used in both transmitter as well as receiver, the transmitter head as well as the receiver. A transmitter consists of the modulating signal. It is also known as information signal, could be your voice data, could be your analog data, or could be your digital data, which is known as modulating signal, and that signal is superimposed with the carrier signal. Now what is the carrier signal? The carrier signal is the signal on which the information is being carried. For example, radio signal, we are going to transmit the voice signal for medium wave and amplitude modulation radio, that is nothing but the AM radio. Now this is nothing but the modulating signal. Now so modulation can be analog or digital modulation. In analog modulation, we can have a amplitude modulation, phase modulation, then frequency modulation, and in digital modulation there are so many techniques are there. For example, QPSK, as you have already understood, quadrature phase shift keying, then BPSK, and so on, which you have understood in last semester in communication engineering subjects. Now after that, we amplify the signal, and therefore amplifier is used, right? After modulator, there is an amplifier block. So after that, there is an impedance matching network, which is essential for the connection between the antenna and the amplifier. Now what is the importance of this? Now antenna may be having certain certain inputs, input impedance, but amplifier may require a different impedance matching. So to match the antenna impedance and impedance matching network is essential, and that is to be a lossless matching network. So lossless matching network generally consists of inductor, capacitors, maybe transmission line or coaxial lines, as you already understood in the antenna wave propagation subject. So once the signal is transmitted to the antenna, it is received by the receiver, and therefore the receiver is there. So the receiver antenna receives the signal, but as you know, it is very very weak signal. So that must be amplified by the RF amplifier. So RF amplifier is the first block of the receiver system. However, there is a need in between antenna and the RF amplifiers that are known as bandpass filter. So sometimes if antenna is a narrow band, it can act as a bandpass filter, or sometimes bandpass filter is built into this RF amplifier. Otherwise, a bandpass filter should be added over here. So bandpass filter is required only to pass the desired band which is required for given application. So then this amplified signal through local oscillator, which is here, that is nothing but the LO block, it is down converted using this mixer, which is one of the super heterodyne concept generally used in the receiver system. So the RF amplifier signal, which is relatively higher frequency, converted down to the lower frequency called as intermediate frequency. So we filter it out and amplify the signal, and then we use a demodulator, which is reverse of this modulator of the transmitter. So if it is amplitude modulator, it will be amplitude demodulator, or if it is a digital modulation, this will be digital demodulation, and then this is connected to the display device or speaker. It depends upon whatever is that application. So this is about the detailed explanation of the antennas in communication system or the wireless communication system. Now so let us just see the various types of the television transmission and receiving antennas. So starting with the television transmission antenna types, there are two basic types. One is transtile array and the other is dipole panel antenna system. Transtile antenna array is used to radiate equal power in all direction, and this antenna is mounted horizontally for better signal to noise ratio. And the dipole panel antenna system used for band 1 and band 3 transmitters. Then I have also discussed the combining network, which is a bridge configuration system where the signal does not interfere with the working of the other transmitter. So let us discuss on transtile antenna array. So as discussed, transtile antenna array is used to radiate equal power in all the directions, and this antenna is mounted horizontally for better signal to noise ratio. Now this is also the omnidirectional radiation pattern in the horizontal plane for equal television signal radiation in all the directions, and therefore since this is a horizontal placement, this kind of arrangement we can say the transtile array arrangement. So in the next slide, so in this slide I have here I have shown the first figure, the resultant pattern, resultant pattern of this figure, and in the next figure the several transtile arrays stack over each other for the mountain. So in this type of antenna, two cross dipoles, if you look here in the first figure, so there are two cross dipoles are fed in quadrature from the same source by means of an extra lambda by 4 line. Each dipole has a figure of 8 pattern. So here each dipole has a figure of 8 pattern in the horizontal plane, but cross with each other. The resultant field in all direction is equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of fields radiated by each conduction to that direction. And this is about the directional pattern in the plane of turnstile array. Now the next slide is about the dipole panel antenna system. So as discussed, the dipole panel antenna system used for band 1 and band 3 transmitter, which consists of the dipole panels mounted on the four sides at the top of the antenna. So you here you are looking the there are four dipole which is mounted, right? So each panel consists of an array of full wave dipoles mounted in front of reflectors. For obtaining the unidirectional pattern, the four panels mounted on the four sides of the tower are so fed that the current in each lags behind the previous by 90 degrees. This is achieved by varying the field cable length by lambda by 4 to the two alternate panels and by reversal of polarity of the current. Now here is the combining network. So combining network, actually it is a bridge configuration. It is a bridge configuration where the signal does not interfere with the working of the other transmitter. This is called as duplexer, or we can say the balancing network, which is equivalent bridge circuit used for feeding picture and sound transmitter, which is feeding for picture and sound transmitter to a common turnstile array, which is shown in this figure. So here this figure illustrated the antenna combining system is a bridge configuration in which first two arms are provided, these two first two arms are provided formed by the two radiators of the turnstile antenna, and the other two arms consist of two capacitive reactants. Now under the balance condition, video and sound signal through radiated by the same antenna and which do not interfere with the functioning of the transmitter other than their own existence. So now here again I have used a balloon. Balloon, it is nothing but the balance unbalanced transformer. Now let us just see the television receiver antennas. So the various types of television receiving antennas, these are used for both VHF, that is very high frequency, and UHF, that is ultra high frequency television channels. The dipoles are used to induce signal current in the antenna conductors, and a match transmission line connects the antenna to the input terminals of the receiver. So it may be noted that the signal pickup by the antenna contains both picture and the sound signal components, or we can say picture and sound information. So after that I have explained some types of the receiving antenna. So folded dipole antenna and the Aguiar antenna. But Aguiar antenna, it consists of the folded dipole antenna. So what do you mean by first the folded dipole antenna? So as shown in the figure, the folded dipole is made of two half wave antennas joined at the ends, where with one open at the center where the transmission line is connected. If you see, there is a transmission line is connected, and the spacing between the two conductors is small compared with the half wave length. This antenna has the same directional characteristics and signal pickup as that of straight dipole, but its impedance is approximately 300 ohms. So if you have calculated the impedance of the half wave dipole antenna, it comes around 72 ohm. Now this is we have to multiply by 4 times. So this is 4 times that is of a dipole. So hence the calculation of the impedance here for the folded dipole antenna is, so 4 multiplied by 72 ohms, so it equals to 288 ohms, and for a half wave dipole with equal diameter arms. But this we can say this is the approximate value for the 300 ohms. So 300 ohms it is required impedance, 300 ohm impedance is required for the television receiving antenna, and that's why we are using the two half wave antennas connected in the folded dipole antenna. Now let us see the Aguiar antenna. This antenna widely used with television receivers for location within 40 to 60 km from the transmitter, and it consists of one folded with one reflector and one director. This is commonly known as Agioda or simply Agioda antenna, or we can say the Agi antenna. Now, this antenna provides a gain close to 7 dB, and it is relatively unidirectional as shown in the radiation pattern of the figure. So, to avoid pickup from any other side, the back lobe, here is the back lobe. So, this back lobe of the radiation pattern can be reduced by bridging the radiators closer to each other. Now, here I have given some constructional diagram of the Agioda antenna. So, in this Agioda antenna, the frequency range is 30 megahertz to 300 megahertz, which is belong to the VHF and UHF bands, as I have already discussed. This figure consists of one reflector, you can see in the diagram, one reflector is there, then one folded dipole, and there are many directors. The reflector which reflects all energy towards the direction of the radiation pattern. It is the lengthy element, as you have seen in the diagram, which is at the end of the structure. The feeder is the folded dipole. So, folded dipole works as a feeder, and the directors which direct the beam towards the desired angle. There are many directors placed to increase the directivity of the antenna. So, the number of whatever the number of directors are you can use, the directivity you will get more directivity of that particular antenna. The center rod, it is nothing but the supporting mass for the in some cases it will call it as a boom. So this is about all the basics of the television antenna, television transmission and receiving antenna. So just to summarize, in this particular video, I have explained basic concept of antenna and why there is a need of an antenna in any communication system. Then I have explained the functionality of transmitter and receiver with the help of the block diagram of wireless communication system. I also quickly look in the various types of antennas for television transmission and the reception point of view. So here is the reference. So all the materials are used for the preparation of this video from monochrome and color television by R.R. Gulati book. And so lastly, thank you.